Hey folks, this is Noble Rambler and welcome to another episode of Farming Simulator 17. We're in Goldcrest Valley. I'm in my old rusty pickup, looking a little aged there in the front grill. And we are at sunset, about 9 p.m. We've still got this humongous field here to finish off. Well, not humongous compared to some of the others, but bigger than anything we've got or had before this. We've still got two fields over here that are ready to harvest. And I've been noticing, see this is withered? We're withering all over the map. So, and these are all ready to harvest, and I assume they're going to wither next. I don't know if the map is going to reset itself. I assume that it would. I was just surprised to see so many of them in the withered stage at the same time. But what I want to do is switch this over to plant withering off, because we've got nighttime coming and I really don't want to record all of this work in the dark. That's just not going to make for a great episode. So going to, because of the difficulty of recording and having so much darkness around, I'm going to go ahead and shut down plant withering to guarantee that it will be there well into tomorrow for us to deal with when the recording is better. Otherwise, I guess we get a couple of things set up for tomorrow and then finish all this. Let me pop out of here. There we go. Let's run over and just get this guy finishing his job. He's got 2 minutes worth left and he's done. And then maybe grab the sower, take it back, and refill it. I think that's a plan. Let's do it ourselves. So what do I want here? B? Yeah. And F, F, F. There's all of our lights. Let's jump in the cab. We'll get this last little bit done. Oh, the sunlight's probably going through the exhaust fumes. That's what's making that strange lighting effect there. Yeah. The sower, I think it's right back over there. Let's see, we are at 54% full. It's odd that we can't see anything dropping in through here. Maybe the quantity is just too small, being such a narrow little band. But this one's almost finished. We'll park this one off to the side, deal with it tomorrow. And see that one. There we go. And we'll dump the grain tomorrow and dump this into there as well. We'll go ahead and put this guy over here. Right there. And I've got to deal with lights. There we are. Let's grab the sower and run back to the farm with it. That's over here. I am stepping on freshly planted soil. There we go. You leave tire prints all over. I've never checked to see if we leave footprints. Doesn't look like it. And then tomorrow morning we'll drive this back and get them all started again. What I might do in between, though I'm going to need the pickup to do that. What we got here? Yeah, we're in the ground. Okay, let's spin this guy around and head back. We might take a drive around, kind of look at all the city at night. Notice that some of the buildings are starting to light up in the distance. Oh, that's right, my own lights. There we go. Looking up at the weather, top right corner, you see we have a cloudy day coming tomorrow. Partly cloudy. So weather is finally going to change for us. What I've found is steering with the keyboard is kind of unpredictable. If I let off on the gas and then turn and then push the gas back down, it makes it, you know, a little bit easier to maintain control. Jump inside for the rest of this. We'll fill this up and park it. I guess transport back to the truck. It's going to It'd be kind of boring to watch me sprint the whole way. But yeah, the wheat is ready to harvest. The sunflower is ready to harvest. First thing tomorrow morning, I guess, get off to the equipment store and pick up the new header. Though we could delay that and do the wheat first. That would make more sense. We put in there corn, right? I think we did, but that doesn't look like little corn to me. Fruit types. No, we did two sunflowers. Okay, that's right, because that one header only did sunflower. Yep, that looks kind of like sunflower. Yeah, okay. The ones that I grow are never that lush at that stage, that full. Usually tall and spindly. Let's back this guy in. I did turn speed down to real time for a moment till we get all of this taken care of so that I didn't have to do all this in the dark. And we gotta grind that stump one more time. That was strange. I really thought that I had ground it the first time, so it'll grind just pieces of wood on the ground with no problem. Let's park this guy just over here, and we'll take off with him in the morning. Just like so. Okay. Those lights will stay on. F there. And there's nothing else to drive here. Every tractor is gone, isn't it? Wow. Alright, so let's see here. I'm thinking a tab. Four tabs to get to the truck. Okay. So tomorrow we'll get the new header. And tonight, let's just drive around a little bit and take a look at some things. See, the lights are on in the building here. We'll see all the headlights on in the cars we pass. Where am I? Let's go this way. Oh, the street lights are on. And my headlights are not. Let me get into the cab there. There we go. Someone in behind us. Been a lot of episodes since we saw the town all lit up at night. But here's the crops I was talking about. All this has died and withered. This is going to have to be plowed under now. So if the map doesn't reset itself, I assume that the farmers would just move on to the next stage on their own. They have been up to this point. So, let me pull out here so we can see more of the town. If not, then I don't want a map with nothing but withered crops everywhere on the map. That's just going to be, you know, ugly for recording. We'll have to go through and work every field to get it going again. And I don't want to commit to that either. So what is still good will remain so, and what isn't, it'll be a good test just to see if the game is going to... Hello! Okay, back inside with me. I cannot drive from out there and talk. Anyway, but I can't see as much from in there. Just want to make a quick loop. Let's kick time back up. We'll go to 30. 30 times normal time. So what's that, every 2 minutes is an hour? Yeah, something like that. Take a loop through town here. Kind of see everything. Going way too fast. There we go. There's the park. I wonder what the farms look like. At night. I wonder how lit up they are. Let's go up to the pig farm real quick and just take a peek. I'm curious. Then we'll call our trip done. This was the path I wanted? Yeah, there's my little mini map down there. This truck stops way too soon. There we go. Okay, back in the cab. A little more confident in my driving from in here. And we're gonna just blast through. I got a turn. There it is. I say we got a turn coming up. All right, clear. Pigs are right up this way. I don't remember seeing any lighting up here. Was that my turn? That was my turn. So I'm curious to see how dark it is. If you wanted to do something with the pigs at night. Where'd the other guy? Here's the other turn. All right. Yeah, it's pretty dark over here. Okay. There may be lighting that you can buy in the placeables menu. So we'll drive through the forest and get back to our fields. And then I guess I'll just go to bed till morning. You know, get up with the roosters. And I don't remember the road going this way. Yeah, that's right. I think it's this side. It looks different at night. Yeah, there we go. There's the sunflowers. Here's our place at night. Alright. So, I am thinking, I'll tell you what, let's sit here for just a moment and kick time up to 120. Let it blast through so you can see what happens at midnight. You see all the finances that come in, you know, the maintenance for the vehicles. Let's see what else there is. But then I will cut away, and at 5 in the morning we'll be up and collect some eggs and go off and get a header and bring the sower back in and get started over there. 10 more minutes. My, how time flies. There we go. So, 6,200 in vehicle costs. A dollar in property maintenance. Okay. And 400 in animal upkeep. Interesting. Property maintenance. What's that about? Finances. Property maintenance, $1. Huh. I have no idea. That Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, today, it was $2, right? Huh. Wonder what property we're talking about that would only equal $1. Huh. Anyway, I will catch you in just a second. Hold on. Alright, we're back. Here in the chicken coop. Says we've got 22 eggs to gather up. Interesting, I sat there in the dark and watched them. And at night, there you go. They all snuggle down like this and roost. And they don't move, they just sit there. And then about 5 minutes to five, they all got up and started moving around. And right at five, they started clucking. They just know what time it is. Alright. We got them all. Yeah, there really should be more of a nesting box area for them to get into and all the eggs in there like would normally happen. There's one. Alright, with that, let's see here. There's still one egg left out here. There usually is. You run around in circles and you never find it. Back on the Westbridge Hills map, seems like there used to always be one up on the roof somewhere. Nope, won't let me. Okay, we have got to go get ourselves a header. Though, how would we do that? Wonder if we should drive this over and get it going, and we'll figure the rest out from there. Squeeze through. Yep. So we are full of seed. Yeah, we have enough fertilizer to do the job. I'm just debating whether to take the... Yeah, we can't take the combine in there to get the header. Need to buy a header trailer to drive it back on. And the combine only drives it for like 14 miles an hour, something like that, so that's going to take forever. I guess we'll take one of these tractors in and go get it. If any of you ever hear of a mod that allows the trains to kind of take off on their own once every couple of hours, just to have them rolling through the track, I'd love to get more information on that. I think that's one thing that the game is missing, is the trains just doing their own thing when you're not attached to them, or not working with them. I think I want to be over here. Oh, we've already gone through a growth stage. That's why it's not looking right. Okay. Well, that'll be fine. We'll make that work. Which means that what I was concerned about, we've already gone to the next stage here and are in danger of losing some of that crop. Because it goes by so quickly in this game. You know, 2 or 3 days represents an entire season, like a month a day. So, let's see this from out here. See if we can get the rows to pretty much line up again. Alright, so we are set to grass. Let's hire him out and bail out of here. Not that one. Here we go. Yeah, that lines up pretty good. Yeah, we'll see. I hate to miss one tiny little strip in here. You know, this part right here. Well, we'll come back and look at it. If we have to, we'll do it manually. Anyway, I've got grain over there. I've got a blue tractor over here. Let's go grab this over here. But before I do, we've got a cultivator, this stuff right over here has got to get going. And that's the last thing to do to finish this field, right? I think so. Yeah. Let's get him on his way. Now, if I were to just... Oh, I see, he just finished right there. That's right. We got to get him started ourselves. He's not a whole lot wider than the tractor, huh? This way. Let him duplicate a little bit. Make sure that everything gets done. Come on, play nice. That's what I'm trying to do. Okay, so V, yeah, and then H, and I'm out of here. I always want to hit that and zoom up in the air. As a habit, I will probably never break. I wish there was a way to take the chainsaw off and only grab it when I need it. Anyway, let's head over to the blue tractor. And too bad I can't just set a header right up onto here. Oh, wait a minute now. When I buy a header, it's not going to come on a tractor. It's going to be on the ground. I'm going to have the combine there, aren't I? Well, that's a little frustrating. I think that's the only way to do it. Well, let's do this. Where's the tongue on this one? Over there. And what's with that? Did that get missed? Kind of looks like it. Huh. Before long, I'm guessing we're not going to be able to tell where the field was versus the grass right here. So what used to be a narrow space between the trees and the field is going to just become a bunch of grass. So I don't know how important it will be to trim all those out because we're using it as grass. But let's just kind of park this guy over here. And I guess let's try and dump some seed into this guy and see if it counts as ours. Make sure it doesn't count as a sell point. Pretty sure that it does not, but not certain. And these little errors right here, I would love to figure out how to clean that up. Maybe I'll go through and cultivate it and reseed it myself, just to make sure nothing gets missed. The helper does tend to miss little spots here and there. Let's roll over to the dump point, and before we dump it, we'll open up the menu that shows our inventory and see if it's increasing. This one over here. Figure out how I want to do this. This will dump even though it's attached, right? Boy, come on. Leave me alone there. I'm just trying to figure out if the hitch moves or if the trailer itself lifts. I think the bed lifts up and the base where the hitch is stays in place. So in that case, try to get into a position where the camera won't freak. Right there. Alright, so G switches you between trailers. Or that one. And what was it? I is unload. Tip side U. There it is. And it's back U. Let's do green door. Okay. Now what did I say I? I for unload. Of course, I for unload. Okay. That's not the right one. Why did it do that? Huh. Okay. Well, let's try the other icon, even though that wasn't it. We're just dumping this one. Okay. Well, be that way. Move you right there, and switch you over to green door with the U right there, and then drop into here. What do I want? This was soy. So 751 is the ending number. We're not increasing our income. But it still says 751. It was soy, right? Yes. But we're not gaining anything from it. All right, let's do it this way. I and 78751. So it's not showing that it's giving it to us. It's just dumping it in here. And I don't really see how to determine what is in here. So let's go back around. Let me get back inside so you can hear me. Here we go. Where's my D? There it is. Let's go back around and grab that grain back out again. And we'll take it to our own silo. So that was an experiment, and I wasn't too comfortable with the results of that. So let's go do what we know works. It's a lot of soy that I don't want to lose because I didn't realize how it worked or didn't work. And I believe everything dumped out of the last one. Let's just make sure. Can I put anything in here? I believe R is what I hit, right? Do you see it? Because I don't. It's not going to give you my grain back, is it? Let's move the other tractor or trailer in. Because it had some room. There it is. If it doesn't have room, it doesn't give you the option. R to start filling. And now I gave it back. We're at 100%. Okay. Well, now I know. Can I go around this building? No. Okay. I'll sneak through here. Hey, where'd that tractor come from? It wasn't there a moment ago. Over G has completed their task. Don't know what that means. I don't think that was enough time for the cultivator to finish. So it may have turned the wrong direction and said, oh, this is all done. 7 miles an hour. This way. Best way into there. I still don't know why I couldn't tip the first trailer. Let's take this wide, try to work our way back in like that. So I'm going to back off so the other one is not able to get in there, and then I'm going to shift back to the front one and hit I. Now it's working. Interesting. So let's, if I were to shift mid, it will not let me. Okay. I couldn't shift to the side if I wanted to right now. Seems like a really slow way to do this. 47 liters of fuel. Ah, take care of that. Right there. And let's see here. G. Unfortunately, there's no indicator to tell me what side. At least I don't think there is. What do I want here? U? U. So nothing changes down below. Nothing changes on the body of it. None of my indicators change. No way of knowing which side I'm going to tip from. So let's take the back right there, and I. That's much faster. Okay. So I guess we'll just bring the What am I doing here? Oh, okay, my finger's in the wrong place. I'm hitting the S for backup with my finger, and I'm hitting the accelerator pedal with my foot, and it's freaking the game out. Let's leave these guys here and bring the combine to here and get it ready to start. We'll dump the combine right into this. Get them started on wheat. While that's happening, we'll go and get the header. So, lights, and I guess best way to do that is just to toggle over. We have to do this a few times. He kind of got done. He made it to there. Let's do something like this and make sure he really gets finished. Higher. Okay, so that's done. This guy's doing his thing. Alright, we want the combine. The sheep over there. So we'll get everything situated and then I'll shift time back to 5x the speed. Once we get comfortable, everything's working. So this guy's half full. Now we know where we're not dumping it. Okay, now he's done for real, I'm guessing. Yeah, there he is down in the bottom corner. Okay. Ah, much quieter. So we'll drive. I'm still not sure how to get the header here. Can you pick up a header with a forklift and put it onto the trailer without the combine doing the work? Because I want the combine to be working on the wheat. I figure I'll do the wheat first so that when we lease the header for this field and the next one, it will have the most amount of time available. In other words, let's get maybe even one more growth stage in on the new crop of sunflower before we lease it, or at least real close to that point, so that we're not over a day. Yeah, we'll see how that works. Anyway, let's dump this off into a trailer, then immediately get him started. And then I guess we could try putting the pallet forks onto the front loader tractor and drive it out there and see if it's possible to do all that. Could rent a large header trailer, put the sunflower header on it, much larger than we need for it, so that we have it for the future, and rather than leasing both pieces. Okay, let's get the tube out. And we'll go for the smaller trailer. Never mind, that's right. He starts as soon as he makes contact. You don't get to choose. Okay, we're going for that one. All right. Obstructions out here anymore, except for that one little stump right there. I always overestimate how quickly this thing can turn. It takes quite a wide sweeping turn there. Alright, hire him. Fill up fast if I What just happened? Okay. It died. Helper I has completed their task. Okay. Well, while I'm thinking about this, enable straw swath. So I don't know which one it is, but it's the comma. I want to make sure we do get the straw. But what happened there? Okay, fire this up and try again. This time I'll do it myself for a while. I'll make sure I'm getting straw. No. There we go. Alright, let's hire this out again. Jump out. Jump out. Grab the chainsaw, zoom up in the air. He's doing fine now. That was really odd. Okay. Well, that's there. Let's go and... Blue tractor. Really? Right there. And we need to remember to go plant that little space over there. I'm going to leave the cultivator here, too, and kind of clean up these edges. But... Let's bring this back. I want to put the front loader forks on him. See, around the tree? Yeah, around the tree. Out. Hitting the base of it there. Well, when I started this episode, I was envisioning getting the other two fields harvested, and even getting the sower going on planting the next field. I don't know if I'm even going to get into finishing one of them. We're already at the 40-minute or so mark. Amazing how fast time flies in this game. Now, if I recall, I think I was just starting to say this last time when the combine died, wheat fills up quickly. We may not be able to really leave to get the header because he's already going to be half full. And we've done a good job of getting all stages of fertilizer in here, so it's going to be a very high yield this time. So I think I might want to race right in there and dump him down. At least it'll give me something to compare to. Dropped that off right over there. Now this guy. See if I can aim that in there straight enough. Like that. Okay. What have we got on? That's not the right button. Got that pallet? That is pallet. Okay. And let's get out to that tractor over there. Okay, let's swap out. I don't see any beacons on yet. Let's go dump the soy first. You know, this one has got the front loader attachment too, and it needs fuel. Let's swap out and take this one to go get the header, and stop by a gas station on the way. That might be a good idea. Alright, so I am on the rear one right now, so there, and I want to switch to the back. Yeah, not Green Door. What is that? I? You. There we go. And I. And do this. That's what I wanted to see. That's been going up like crazy. And he's done. Okay. Let's go dump the other one down. I'm just noticing the weather symbol there. It says partly cloudy. See the clouds? It was a nice blue sky before. Get to where I can see where I'm going here. Kind of clouds coming in. Not too many, though. But I'm wondering if it's going to switch over to a rain symbol next. Seems like every 6 hours, maybe, it makes a transition. Still no beacons. Okay. Gotta wait for him to turn around anyway. The fill tube's on the other side, or dump tube. So that is 1, 2, 3, 4. Up, down, up, down. Okay, so 2 complete cycles. Let's see how much is in there. Not for that matter. So that is 2/3. And I've already got the right cruise control. I said the helper bee was blocked by an object while we were doing that, but it was too noisy to mention it. Was that me and him, or something in the way of the sower over there? Don't know how to cycle through to see who was helper bee. Anyway, this one needs gas. So let's see, we're on the front one, so I can queue and do that. Pop out of here. Got enough room there. Oh, I just realized what I did. Where's the rest of it? Oh, man. Okay. Let's see here. I want to G to that one. Q that. Back up. Oops, forward. Something like that. Okay. So we'll leave him parked there. Jump through here. Oh, like I've done this before. Okay, so you up and you down, something like that. All right, so 1, 2, 3, 4. And we started undoing him on that fifth one. So he's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, we're not going to get there and back in time. Let's see that. Well, tell you what. We'll leave it on 1 speed. That way we're not worried about timing. We'll finish him up next episode if we have to. I want to see what happens when we lease a header and a combine's not there to pick it up. Yeah, this looks kind of ugly with all these gray crops around. That's too bad. Go this way. Oh, I see, that's just access to this field. It's not access to the road. Nobody in that direction. Nobody in that direction.
You'll never know.
Except for the tired mud prints I left behind. That'll give me away. Next episode, we'll switch it over to 5-speed again and get the day progressing. Probably should put the beacons on, huh? Here we go. I'm going to turn early rather than going in the other end. Go into this end. Of course, over here, you got, well, I guess both ends, you got pedestrians to work through. Was the sound of that flag up there I just heard. That's right, fuel. Was there not a gas station nearby? What do I want? Can I see that sort of thing on here? I really can't. It just squares. Okay. Let's gas this guy up. I don't know. I've seen gas over in other parts of the map. I know there's one here somewhere, but I can't actually recall right now where I saw it. Boy, we're going to run out of gas before we find it. There must be one back in this area. That over there? There it is. You think we know where the gas station was? We lived here for a whole, 4 days now? At least I'm guessing this is our 4th day in the game day. Alright, so we'll pull up over here. I'm hoping it's R for refuel. It is. Okay. Watch the bank account plummet. That's some serious money leaving there. How big a tank does this guy have? Probably that guy right there. That's it. A little 10-gallon right there. Something doesn't seem right. Okay, let's go get our header now. No fuel. Gasoline is expensive, but that's ridiculous. Alright, see if I can find the stores from here. Right up there. Bumper C is a full tank, and Bumper C is going to sit there with his full tank for a while. We're on a mission. Alright, so let's talk about leasing. Headers? The Capella Sunflower fits the 1660. Select. Going to cost us $36.30 and $3.30 more each day that we have it, assuming we don't run it over one operating hour, which actually is very doable when we're running it real time. It takes, you know, an entire 1 hour episode. We could easily move through two fields with it. So we're going to lease this guy. It does tell me it's 5.7 meters long. Okay, back. We need a header trailer. Here. And unfortunately, there's no way to know which one is which. There's no lengths. So I'm guessing I have these two to choose from. We don't need to go that route. So let's get this one. It'll work for the next one that we pick up as well. It'll probably work for about anything that we pick up. So grab that. Color. I have no idea. Let's make it an off-white. That'll stand out. We won't lose that one. $500 to paint it, though. Oh, well, you only live once. Buy it. Now, how do we get the one onto the other? That's what I'm curious about. I'll bet you the forklift cannot interact with this in any way. That's what I wanted to experiment with, just to verify. You'd think I could slide right into this space here, lift up hook underneath the black bar, and swing it in. But it doesn't always work the way that you assume. Yeah, something like that. All right, let's see what happens. It isn't actually a space there. Okay, I'm hitting right now. So if we take it down, tilt it, can I get under it? No. So I probably cannot interact with that. Let's try from the other side just one time. Otherwise, I'm going to have to drag the harvester down here just to lift that up and put it in the trailer. For that matter, I guess I may as well just not put it in a trailer. Yeah. I can't flip it up in the air or anything. Okay. Yeah, that's disappointing. Now I know. So, with that, where's my... There it is. Beacon's off. I think I gotta call this one done. Didn't get all done that I wanted to, but that's what next episode is for. So I'm going to call this one finished. This has been Noble Rambler. Thanks, guys, for watching, and I will catch you next time. Bye-bye.